Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Charmaine and today I'm gonna be sharing with you three food spots that I frequented very often when I was living in Taiwan. So if you're new to my channel and you don't know what's going on, why am I talking about Taiwan, then please do subscribe to my channel because in my channel I talk a lot about Taiwan, Mandarin, Chinese, food in Taiwan and all that stuff. Alright, without further ado, let's move on to the first spot that I often go to when I was living in Taiwan. So the first food stop would be Ba Fang Yun Ji. So this spot, okay, I'm telling you, I am not lying when I say I go there so often. There was even 1 week where I ate Ba Fang Yun Ji for like 5 days consecutively. So in this store, they sell dumplings with a variety of flavors, even vegetarian options, and they sell noodles. They sell soup, drinks, soy milk, and all that stuff. So a couple of my favorite go-to dishes over there would be 招牌锅贴, 韩式辣锅贴, and just plain old noodle and soup. So whenever I go to this food stop, I always get number one, 招牌锅贴, number two, 韩式辣锅贴, number three, 汤面. I forgot the name of it, but I'll insert it over here. So whenever I'm on a budget or I'm craving for dumplings, fried dumplings, steamed dumplings, boiled dumplings, noodle soup, and something to keep me warm and make me feel like I'm at home, I would definitely head over to Ba Fang Yun Ji. So they actually do have a competitor, but I've never really tried that place before. So I'm just gonna be talking about Ba Fang Yun Ji because I've been there so many times. So I definitely have to mention it. So if you love dumplings, you're on a budget, you want good food, then head over to Ba Fang Yun Ji. You will not regret it. Alright, moving on to the second food stop, and that is Ding Hao Shao Zi Mian.
I was editing halfway and I realized that I got the restaurant name wrongly. So the real name is Ding Hao Zi Ling Zhen Jiao Guan. Sorry about it.
So whenever it's a Sunday and I do not know what to eat, I would definitely head over to
Ding Hao Zi Ling Zhen Jiao Guan.
So how did I find out about this place? And it was through BuzzFeed. So BuzzFeed Worth It went to this dumpling store that Inka introduced to Steven and Andrew. So I went over to try it for myself because she mentioned that her grandma grew up eating at this store. So I was like, oh, it definitely has to be good, right? So I tried it and it was so good. Like, I cannot even explain, like the flavors. Oh, the flavors was popping, okay? And if you love dumplings, you love beef noodles, you love beef patties, you have to try this place. I go to this place almost, okay, not almost. Whenever I do not know what to eat on a Sunday, I would definitely head over to this store. There are so many dishes to try over there that I feel like ordering every single item on the menu whenever I'm there. But I definitely would get their 锅贴, 炸酱面, as well as beef pancake, 牛肉葱煎饼, if I'm not wrong. Okay, but those are my top three. But whenever I'm there, I feel like ordering every single thing. But because I'm only like 2% or 3% eating, so I can't really order everything. And for me, whenever I'm there, I want to try new dishes. But when I look at the menu and I look at the people around me eating, I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna stick to my usuals. There are so many good dishes there. There's the egg drop soup, the sweet and sour soup, steamed dumplings, so many more, okay? But you definitely have to try it out. It's authentic, it's so good. The flavors are bursting. It's worth the money. There's so many ingredients. I always leave there with a food coma. So you definitely have to try.
Ding Hao Zi Ling Zhen Jiao Guan.
You won't regret it. It was so worth it. Alright, the last food stop for today would be Liu Mama Fan Tuan. This is more like I heard it from a local that this place sells amazing fan tuans. So Fantuan is like a thing, like a breakfast stop or just a snack for many Taiwanese over in Taiwan. And this Liu Mama Fantuan is very famous. It closes at 11 a.m. every single day. You can only get it from about 5 a.m. to 11 a.m. every single day. But it is amazing. It's so worth it. It's about $5 for a huge rice roll. Like, oh, I cannot. Oh my gosh, I miss the taste. Okay, so what they have over there would be rice. And they have a multiple options for you already, but you can definitely make your own fantuans. So what's inside a fantuan is usually a youtiao, chicken floss, preserved vegetables, egg. Oh my gosh, I can't even remember what's in there. But I'll list it down over here for you to see, or maybe some cross sections of fantuans that I found on Instagram. What's amazing about this Liu Mama Fantuan is that they provide not only white rice, they also provide purple rice. The flavors you get from it is definitely, if you want to try the local flavors, this Liu Mama Fantuan is it for you. Maybe you won't like the preserved vegetable taste, or maybe you wouldn't like the youtiao, the oiliness of the youtiao, but you can always opt for that to be taken out. But either way, when you eat it, wow, it's healthy, it's worth it, it's huge. Oh, the taste stays in your mouth and you just crave for it the next day as well. If you're a rice lover, if you love exotic flavors, then definitely try Liu Mama Fantuan. Every time I'm there, there's a queue, so you know it's good, right? Okay, honestly, all these three places, they all have a queue whenever I'm there. But you definitely have to try it if you're into finding out the locals' food and, you know, getting the best from the neighborhood. Alright, those are the three food stops that I'm recommending it to you today, because I frequented it so very often that I have to share it with you, you know? Ugh, I miss those three places so much. I miss good dumplings, good noodles. I'm so sad that I can't try it right now. But anyway, if you ever head over to Taiwan to study, live, travel, definitely visit these three places that I frequented so often. And I know that after I share this, maybe there will be a queue, even longer queue over at those three stops. But you know what? Good food, good places, good things, I have to share them. So thank you. I mean, you're welcome that I'm sharing them with you. But yeah. I hope you enjoy these three places, and that is all that I have for you today. Oh, my camera just died on me. I'm so sorry about it, and I'm sorry if the angle changed. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you love the three spots that I recommended to you. And in the near future, I would definitely be sharing with you more food places, more places to visit, more cafes, and all the good stuff. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!